Right, so what's the best thing about being part of the order?
I'm not part of the order.
No, the show, the order, not the order.
Someone hasn't done the research.
No, the show.
Just teasing. Honestly, the best part is the people you get to work with. I don't know. You guys have met some of them now, hopefully. They're showing their awesome true selves. Like, hopefully they're not like so nervous that they I'll tell you. But yeah, a lot of great people. A lot of people I knew before the show, actually. So Jake and I went to high school together, actually.
Wow.
Same grade, same high school. It's a big high school, big city as well. So it's just a crazy coincidence. All this time later, getting to work together in a major way.
We liked each other in high school.
Yeah, we did. Okay. I mean, it was such a big school that there were, like, you know, a lot of, you know, different like friend groups and stuff. I mean, ours like overlaps quite a bit, but we really connected after school because we were both trying to get into acting, so we'd stay in touch and, you know, talk about like if we had any advice for each other, or just like how's it going in Toronto. He was in Toronto, I was in Vancouver. So and then yeah, I knew Sarah before, I knew Larisa before, I knew of Katie and her work. So very excited to work with these people's answer.
Looking back on the first season, if you were to tell someone who hasn't seen the show yet, look at this episode, this is my episode, this defines my character, what episode would they watch?
I would probably say episode 3. It's the episode where you first actually meet the wolves. I mean, the first 2 episodes, you don't even know for sure if my character, if he is a werewolf yet or something. I think they're teasing that he's like a killer, but that wasn't true. But episode 3, I think the show really opens up. You know, it opens the door to a whole other subplot. And I think the werewolf stuff in there is really fun. Introduce Jake, like a naked Jake, Jack. I don't know which one sometimes. So yeah, that's hard. Sometimes all of a sudden I'm like, Jake, I'm Jack. Because I go to say Jake because his name is Jake. It's always been Jake. I lost the question. What was it?
That episode that defines your character.
Yeah, episode 3 definitely defines my character and his motivations, why he's trying to essentially help Jack, you know, like, into turning him into a superhero. Like Randall, like, isn't this fun? He doesn't realize he's creating a lot of problems for this guy. He just is trying to avenge his mother's death.
Did they give you a big backstory to go along at the beginning, or no?
No.
Didn't know anything about
Randall be Randall, you know?
Do you like that?
I do. You know, it's more mysterious, and then they can kind of add in those elements later on as they see fit. I know Hamish, Thomas Elvis' character, had a very elaborate backstory. But, Randall's was pretty simple, actually. It's just like, he, like, we saw like a fight going on, or like a child abduction or something, and he stopped it, and then one of the current wolves was like, do you want to like have superpowers? And he's like, sure. It's so simple.
Yeah, who would turn that down?
Yeah, exactly.
So we kind of got to see something start up between Randall and Lilith, and then as it starts, you get the rug pulled out from under you. Do you hope to kind of get back to that at some point in season 2?
Oh yeah, for sure. These two characters kind of realize they have feelings for each other pretty late in the season, Randall and Lilith, and I think it'd be nice to explore that more, that relationship more. I love working with Devery, and I think the character dynamic is really funny. Like, Lilith definitely wears pants in the relationship. If there was a relationship, but I think, it'll be interesting to see, since we don't have our memories, like, if we still have a connection, maybe. So,
I see a lot of similarities to your character in Arctic Air.
Oh, whoa, someone's done their research.
It's a beast for Romney Films.
Oh, wow, okay.
But I'm curious to know if you feel that way. It almost seems like if you were transplanted
into
university.
That's something I didn't even think about, but now that we're thinking about it, maybe. Yeah, a little bit. I mean, as an actor, I always try to, like, bring myself to the role. And I feel like both of those characters are kind of definitely exploring my goofier side. Randall definitely thinks he's a lot cooler than the character on Arctic Air. I haven't thought about that show in a while, so I'm like,
it's kind of a throwback Thursday for you.
Yeah, Alex Bonovic was on that too.
From I know, Canada. I wanted to get him. That's where
I met him, and we're friends. And he's met my dad in something with me as well. Which is
amazing.
Really cool. But, sorry, what was the question?
Just curious if you found that way.
Any similarities?
And in terms of the humor of it, how much of that is improv? How much of that is written? Or how much do you bring to the table for that?
We have very funny dialogue written, but just part of my process that I've discussed with Dennis as well, as I like to throw my own ideas out there, and they don't have to take them. Like, well, what if I said like this line, just because we have the other way, we've shot it like 5 times, why not like throw a new line in there? I do it respectfully, but yeah, they do let me play around quite a bit, which I'm hoping to do even more of, you know, in a respectful way, not to make the scene about something completely different, just like, you know, try to add some of my own flavor, my own sense of humor to it, which I hope comes across.
Who are you hoping to get to interact with more in season 2?
Interact with more? What are more scenes? I really liked the character of Kyle in season 1. He was played by Jedediah Goodacre. He was like Sarah, Alyssa's like initial like love interest, using the order. And I really wanted some scenes with them together. Yeah, but I guess he's dead now, so can't do that. Maybe if he comes back as a ghost or something. I just thought they would have had a good like banter off. You know, they're a very lippy fellows.